What are you doing, Max? What are you doing? Where are you?
The White House.
The White House? Excuse me? Did you say the White House? In front of the executive building.
This is the Treasury Department. This is so cool. You could see the Capitol building just at the end of the street. Max is getting frustrated because the cars keep driving by and ruining his shot. Tell me about the pool. What is it?
It's not even a foot deep.
It's shallow?
Yes.
What's this over here, Max?
Like it over there. And over there is a
what's over
Martin Luther King statue.
No, sweetie. This is where Martin Luther King's speech was.
Can I get like a penny?
No, you can't get.
We went to the National Aquarium.
Wait, look at this. Freaky with their sharp things.
Yeah. Maxwell really loved the fish there. He especially loved the crocodiles.
Hotel. My feet hurt.
I know. My feet hurt too. All right, this is our train, buddy. This is the pool at the hotel. Maxwell was loving it. This is the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum. It's the annex out in Virginia.
So,
What do you think, Max?
Blackbird.
Wow, look at that. That's a blackbird. One of my favorite aircraft, the F-14 Tomcat. This is an F-4 Phantom. Of course, this B-29 Super Fortress is the Enola Gay, which dropped the bomb on Hiroshima, Japan, in World War II. You may wonder why it's called the Enola Gay. It's actually named after the pilot's mother. Of course, Paul Tibbets was the pilot of this plane. This plane, named Windy, after the founder's daughter, is the very first Federal Express plane. Basically, it was a private plane, private jet, that was converted into a cargo plane. Of course, this plane is the Concorde, a supersonic passenger transport that flew passengers routinely from New York to London and Paris. This plane can go Mach 2, that's twice the speed of sound. This is Maxwell landing the space shuttle.
Great job.
Yeah, we'll keep it right
up
there.
To 2,000 and velocity of 70.
Yep. Power for velocity, you're gonna flip the last switch and that's
this space shuttle, Discovery, flew 149 million miles on 39 missions, the most of any spacecraft. It's absolutely amazing to see in person because you can still see all the burn marks from the re-entry. This spacesuit was worn by James Irwin in 1971 on Apollo 15 mission to the moon. You can still see how dirty it is with all the moon dust. It's amazing.